you know, Drew Brees, I think his legacy is going to be defined as, you know, I think it's going to be twofold. One, if you ever saw Drew Brees throw the ball, I think Drew Brees is the best pure passer of the ball. Like, the way the ball looks and just the delivery and putting it exactly where it needs, the timing is impeccable. It's undeniable that nobody matches up the timing that Drew Brees had. Nobody matches up just the way, the aesthetic of the ball and the way it would come out of his hand, you know, and being a shorter quarterback, especially at the time where he started his career, 2004. Shorter quarterbacks were not, or 2001, shorter quarterbacks, they weren't a thing. Like, there's a reason Doug Flutie spent like 14 years, and he was like 5'11". He spent 14 years in the CFL, not the NFL, you know? So Brees was playing in the time, and he overcame all of that. And he became one of the best passers in the NFL. He's held like almost every single season passing record there is. The dude, he's a stat machine, but he's just greatness personified. And I think that, you know, he's obviously first ballot Hall of Famer. But I think the other thing that people are going to talk about is where does he rank up there as far as, you know, all-time greats? And that's like a whole different conversation, I think. I think that, you know, he's obviously not Brady. He's not Elway, or he's not Montana. He's not like top five. He's not Unitas even. Like, I think Brees would probably, all-time list, probably just be around that like, maybe the bottom of the top 10, top of the top 15 kind of thing, you know, because the thing that he has against him, unfortunately, even though that's one Super Bowl that he has was amazing and what it did for the city, that's also a part of his legacy, just what he meant, what that Super Bowl and what he meant to New Orleans. It's beyond explaining. I don't even need to explain it. Hello, Grumpy 5916. But Brees is just, you know, Brees is going to go down as one of the all-time greats, first ballot Hall of Famer. And honestly, for me, I think the best quarterback to watch, because every time you were watching him, it felt like he was either breaking a record or he was like tying a record or he was doing something like that. So, gonna miss Brees.
Yeah, man. And like you said, you know, a question now for the Saints is, where do the Saints go from here? Like, where do the Saints, I mean, they've got some, you know, great pieces already. Like, they have some great pieces already. You know, the defense, that defense is great with Cam Jordan, everything like that, with the corners and everything like that. Sean Payton's obviously a very good coach, but, you know, you get a first ballot Hall of Famer like that. It's very, you know what I'm saying? Like, you don't replace that. Even Denver. Remember Denver a couple years ago? Even though Denver did have, you know, it was a late, very, very, very late iteration of Peyton Manning, you know, they still have not.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
they haven't recovered.
First ballot Hall of Famer like that, dude, you don't replace that. And don't get me wrong. I mean, Jameis Winston is a talent. I know Taysom Hill has been there forever. He kind of knows the system and everything. But, you know, I'm not going to say this is necessarily a rebuild because the Saints have been so good for so long. But, you know, I am expecting them to take a step back and, you know, we'll see what happens from there. You know what I'm saying? There's been people have been saying around that Michael Thomas might be – he's been having some issues with within the organization. He might ask out.
I mean, Michael Thomas has always had issues with everybody, it seems like.
But it's like, you know, I mean, this is just speculation, but, you know, there's been people who have said that, you know, with the hiring of Urban Meyer in Jacksonville, you know what I'm saying? Like, even though Jacksonville is not
I don't see that happening. I don't think that's going to happen. I think that, you know, the point you're trying to get at, and for those who were asking in the chat, yes, Drew Brees did officially retire, according to Jay Glazer from Fox. Yep. So
he already had a deal. I think he already had a set to be like the next like Tony Romo or something like that.
Yeah,
like,
had a deal. They're gonna take him on Fox, I believe. But
yeah, he's gonna be the next Tony Romo. It'd be interesting who they put him with. I want to see who they put him with.
Yeah, I mean, because he's not gonna be. I mean, for God's sakes, I would love. I just don't put him with Joe Buck. No, I don't want to see him with Joe Buck. Because Joe Buck, I hate watching Joe Buck call games. Sideline, touchdown! No, I don't want to hear that with Drew Brees. No. Where do you see Drew Brees as far as, you know, rankings in quarterbacks? Like, all-time rankings.
You know what? It's weird because he's one of those players where he is a first ballot Hall of Famer. And when you look at him, you know, he's not your stereotypical, like, he's not your stereotypical quarterback. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's not the big, like, he's not big like Cam. So he's not big and imposing, but he's also not Peyton Manning. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's not big like those guys. But, you know, when you look at like the body of work and everything like that, you know, they've made the playoffs how many years of his career? He is statistically the most accurate passer in the history of the NFL. And he does have that Super Bowl. So, I mean, personally, I think, like you were saying before, I think I would put him maybe on like the lower end of the top 10, which, by the way, that is not slighting him at all, because think about all the greats that have come and played that game at that level. That is not slighting him at all to be in the top 10 of anything, especially at that position with all the greats that have played the game. I'd put him right there. I mean, he's definitely a first ballot Hall of Famer. Like, that's for sure. So, just given, but dude, like, think about what he's had to overcome, dude. Think about it. Wasn't the biggest guy, didn't necessarily go to a football power. He did come out of a conference that, you know, has a football power, did not come out of a football power, and he defied the odds, dude. Like, think about what he did for the city of New Orleans, man. He won that Super Bowl for them. First time ever. I remember watching that Super Bowl when I think it might have been Joe Buck who was calling the game when he said, for the first time in franchise history, this is the first time in franchise history that the New Orleans Saints are lining up in victory formation in the Super Bowl. And I was like, that's what Drew Brees did for that city, man. So that's all I got to say about Drew Brees, man. I mean, one of my favorite quarterbacks ever. And I just, you know, I wish him the best. You know, he's a great football mind. He's probably going to do great in the booth. So,
yeah. And we're going to love watching him, you know. Sad to see you go, but, you know, in reality, he's not really going to go anywhere. But
nope. Hey, guys, thanks for watching. We appreciate it. For more content, please like, hit that notification bell, like, comment, subscribe, and everything like that. And just remember, keep it real.